So then Paris was like, I'm gonna need to fact check all of your work because your work isn't up to Harvard standard. And she finds it really annoying that she has to do more work than everyone else because not everyone is on her level. Yeah. I know. I believe I'm Harvard standard too, but you know, maybe I'm not. Like, it is a really good school. Yeah, you're right. I shouldn't doubt myself. It's just so hard, that girl. She just gets in your head so easily. Yeah. Mom, stop messing. He just wants to take our order. No, he's walking away now. I really want breakfast and more coffee, you know? Oh, this is Paris. I need to take it. Outside, can you order for me and apologize to Luke? You know I need to take it outside because it looks all no phone policy. Not everyone wants to annoy him like you, Mom. Okay, I'm just gonna go outside. You remember to order for me, okay? You know what I want, right? Yeah, okay. I did the research. You know, I always do my work. Oh, it is up to standard. Anyway, we're not debating now. What's the problem? I'm not late. Just because you're early doesn't mean I'm late. You're bored. Oh, just do some extra work or something. Isn't that what you do for fun? Anyway, I'll be there when I'm gonna get there. When we agreed, so yeah, I have to get back to breakfast, my mom. Yeah, we're at Luke's. Okay, bye-bye. See you later. Typical, not even a goodbye. That girl may be good at school, but she needs to get better with people, you know, if she wants to be a doctor or a lawyer or whatever. You have to have good people skills, you know. Anyway, better get back to my mom. Yeah, she was just checking that I did the work. Yeah, I know, right? When have I not done anything for school? Also, she claimed I was late. No, we didn't agree to meet earlier. She just had to be dropped off of school earlier. So, you know, she called me trying to get me to come earlier. I don't even know, like, but not happening. Oh, yes, thanks, Luke. French toast, Mom. I know, but I had pancakes 2 days already, and you know, I want some French toast. So, halfsies. Perfect. Oh, thank gosh, Luke, I need some coffee. I'm gonna have to deal with a lot of Paris today. It's only my first cup, Luke. I swear. I mean, this will be my second, but you know. Okay, fine, but you know, Mom is way worse. Thanks, Luke. Yeah, it's too late. I'm already hooked. No one makes coffee like you. It's not flattery, it's the truth. But Mom, yeah, that's why you just try using flattery instead of insults. Gets the first cup of coffee. Nope, no stealing mine. Get your own. Oh, so delicious. Anyway, let me try these pancakes and your French toast. Oh, so delicious. You know, even though I made the big deal, like, the pancakes, so good as well, you know. Yours is so good too, yeah. I was really feeling French toast, but you know, can't really complain. Best of both worlds. You should put this on the menu like this, Luke. Yeah, I know you don't like changing the menu. So, do you really want to know what the project is about? Yeah, well, it's about the colonization of Europe. And we want to go really in depth and do a really detailed project, of course. And became increasingly expressionist following the conquest of in 1415, aiming to control navigation to the Strait of Gibraltar, spread Christianity and all of this. And oh, I can tell I'm boring you, right? Oh, but you know, if you fall asleep, I'll just drink all your coffee, so you know. I know that would wake you right up. Typical, of course, you don't really want to hear about school like you say you do, but like, do you really? Actually done talking about school as well, but I don't want to tell you about Jess and I. Hey, I'm not staring. I'm just like lost in thought, you know, when that happens. Well, I think we're doing something this weekend, but you know, we haven't made like firm plans, and you know, Jess, he's not so reliable with calling, you know, when he says he will, or we never really exactly have firm plans. You know, with Dean, he would always make plans. We'd always make plans beforehand, and he'd always call when he said he would. You know, he was so reliable. I know. It's not fair to compare the two. I wanted Jess. I got Jess. You know, well, at least I think I do. Okay, yes, Dean was amazing, great, reliable. But Jess is who I wanted. It's a mystery. He likes reading. He's sweet in a different way and stuff like that. Oh, I know. I'm still comparing them. Let me just eat my pancakes. So good. So good. Hey, no school. No boys. What are we left with? Food. The French toast is good too. Luke should really add this to the menu. My favorite food, pizza. Drink, is that even a question? Coffee, of course. Speaking of, I need some coffee for the road. Watch and learn, watch and learn. Oh, sweet mother. Luke, can I have some more coffee? No, can I have it for a takeaway? I know you don't have any takeaway cups, so I took the liberty of taking my own. I stole it from Weston's on my way here. I know you don't approve, but I have a really long day ahead of me. Need one more delicious cup of your coffee, and you know, it will help me be so studious and get straight A's at school, you know, just from your coffee. Great. Thank you so much. Have a good day, Luke. See, Mom, that's how it's done. Gotta run for the bus, or perhaps we'll have a stroke. Wanna come, or wanna finish up here? Yeah, I know running didn't sound like the most appealing thing. You go finish your breakfast, and you know what's left of mine. Okay, bye, Mom. Bye, Luke. Thanks for the coffee. Thank gosh I made the bus. It was a close one. Oh, I've got a text. Oh, Paris again. Jeez, that girl does not know how to take the hint. I'm gonna have to deal with that later, but not right now, so I'm not gonna answer her. Let me see. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna read something. Okay. Oh, I forgot my book. Oh well. I'm here. We've been over this. You're early. I'm not late. Fine, I'm 5 minutes late because the bus got caught in traffic. But there was no need to call me and tell me I was late when I was having breakfast with my mom when you were just early, you know. Okay. Well, you know, my business hours start at 9. I'm not answering multiple annoying texts from you. You knew I was coming. Well, then you should have trusted me. You're putting more work onto yourself by not trusting me, you know. Whatever you think, but either way, let's just get started on the project. So, I actually forgot my research. Calm down, Paris. It was a joke. You need to lighten up a bit. So, I was thinking we need to get a more comprehensive idea of the whole history of colonization and think of some positives. some benefits that come about from colonization, because right now we only have a lot of the negatives. Okay, good. You were thinking the same. So yeah, here's my research so far. Let me just give you, you know, a moment to read that, you know. Even you can, you know, read in every, like, 5,000 words in, like, 1 second, you know. Okay, well, besides a few spelling mistakes, remember, it is an oral presentation. I know, it's good to practice good spelling, and yes, I didn't forget the report, but besides what did you think? Like, you know, it's just a few mistakes, just ignore them for now, I'll fix them, of course. Wait, I think that's the nicest thing you've ever said to me. Oh my gosh. Don't worry, I won't get used to it. I think we've got the beginnings of a solid presentation, probably much better than anyone else. Is there anything else we have to discuss before class starts? I think the best use of our time before class is kind of figuring out which themes we should use or research, so we can do our own research about this on our own, so we don't do the same thing and, you know, waste time. Okay, let's just, like, work on that separately for now, okay? And, like, brainstorm some more ideas and go back to that, okay? Okay, well, I think that was a great start. Oh, looks like classes are starting. We should get to our class. Well, I'll let you do that, but I'm going to get going, so I'm not late, you know. Yes, I remember what we discussed. I took notes, okay? I focused more on the positive and continued that path you were on, and you continued down the path you were on, yeah? I know what you said, I was just confirming. Okay, bye for now. Hey Lane, I'm so glad to see you. How was your day? That's good to hear. What did I do today? Well, first I went to Luke's in the morning with my mom. That was about the only good part until now. Yeah, I know, I'm a bit of a nerd. Yeah, I usually do enjoy school, but just we've got this big project coming up and, you know, Paris, yeah, she's being really annoying about it. Like, more than usual. I don't know what's up with her, if there's something up. But yeah, she was calling me at Luke's because she was at school early. So I don't know, maybe her nanny had dropped her off earlier. And then, like, she was saying I was late, even though she was just early, like, you know, trying to, like, gaslight me or something. And then when I was in the bus, she was texting me some more, like, when I was gonna get there and all of that. But I was on my way, you know, what we agreed on, or, you know, the plan. Yeah, when she did call me, it looks like I did go outside because of the whole no cell phone rule. I don't want to piss Luke off, even though my mom, like, relish, like, loves doing that sort of stuff, you know, but oh well. So then she was, like, pointing out all the spelling mistakes, my research, and there wasn't a lot. There was, like, maybe over 5,000 words. Yeah, my research was 5,000 words long. And, you know, it's an oral presentation as well, like, do have to do a report, but that was for the oral presentation part, you know, mostly. And, like, that wasn't the final copy, you know. Either way, she gave me a kind of compliment, so that was good. Yeah, I almost died of shock. Like, she said, and I quote, "This isn't half bad." Like, what's with that, you know? I know, but I mean, 4 powers, this is about the best you're gonna get, like, really. Yeah, I do like the school. I mean, it's further away, it's more work. And of course, I miss you and, you know, Jess. And I could live without Paris in a lot of my life, but I guess, you know, she pushes me to be better. But I just wish she could go about it in a nicer way, you know what I mean? Yeah, well, it's just like she was saying something about her having to do more work because I'm not up to Harvard standards and just... And you know just how hard, like, I want to get into Harvard and how badly I want to go to Harvard. And yeah, it's like I've made studying my whole personality just get into Harvard. And now she's saying I'm not up to Harvard standard. I'm, like, starting to think that, like, maybe she's right, you know. Yeah, I do like. was just for pleasure, you know. I would focus on learning things that I enjoy, and of course I would spend more time with you and Jess, of course, but you first, you know, girls before boys. But seriously, then you'll always be my number one. Boys come and go, friendships are forever, and you know, I just want to spend more time doing the things I enjoy and like reading for pleasure. Reading is not reading, Lane. Like, some reading is for fun, some is just to get good grades in school, and a lot of the time, because of children, like, a lot of my reading is just to get good grades. Well, wouldn't life, like, be awful boring without school, you know? Like, what would you do all day, you know? Maybe that's just me then, but, you know, you have your music, and the band, like, studying is kind of, like, my hobby. That sounds really bad, but it kind of is, you know? Well, you could be. You could get famous. I'll always be your number one, first supporter, best friend, but, you know, the band could do well. Yeah, you're right. This has gone very heavy very quickly. Let's try to lighten it up, you know? Thanks, Lane. I just need to forget sometimes that just because Paris says something doesn't mean it's true. Like, she is smart, but she's not God, you know? She doesn't, can't tell the future or whatever, so I'll just focus on doing well and do my presentation and also try to enjoy school and have a balance. And yeah, we'll just kind of see what happens. So, what are we going to talk about next? Oh no, not Dean. We'll never pass the Bechdel test. What? You haven't heard of it? It's a measure of the representation of women in film and other fiction. The test, you know, asks whether a work features at least two female characters having a conversation about something other than a man. So thus, you ask me about Dean, and probably you mentioned Jess means we failed. Yeah. You know, it's harder than it seems. Like, you think, like, wow, like, you know, over the course of a full film, like, of course two women would have to, you know, talk about, you know, something other than just a man, you know, how their day been. But if they were, you know, having a long conversation, if a man came up into the part of the conversation and they started talking about that, you know, they would fail. And it's harder than you would think, you know, a lot of movies fail. Okay, well, what about you? Oh, yeah. I know, I'm so sorry, Lane. I was blabbing about me too much, but of course you've got so much going on as well. It's just hard to turn off that Chilton brain, you know. Grades, study, all of that, all the time they drill it into you, college, you know. But yeah, always analysing the situations, yeah, and, you know, just trying to bring the Bechdel test and other things into everyday conversation, you know how it is. Well, maybe you don't, but this project is really, you know, challenging, and I also have a really big English paper coming up, but I picked the portrayal of women in mass media. It's a fascinating topic, really, but yeah, let you can talk now. Sorry, no more school. Oh. So, what about Dean? Okay, you saw him at Dozie's. Well, you know, that's not surprising. You know, he does work there, Lane. Oh no, he looked sad. Really? He asked about me? What did he say? So he just asked how I was. What did you say? You said I was good, and did he say anything else? He asked if I was still with Jess. What did you say? Yeah, I guess that makes sense. I am with Jess. But how did he react? He seemed upset. You didn't rub it in his face, did you? Okay, but wait, isn't he with Lindsay? Now, why does he care if I'm changed as if he's with Lindsay? Do you think he still likes me? You don't know. Why do I care? That's a good point. I guess we were just gossiping, you know. Am I sure? Yeah, I'm sure it's nothing else, of course, yeah. I'm still into Dean, of course. I'm not still into Dean, sorry. Of course, I'm with Jess. Hey, that's different. I know I, you know, was into Jess a bit when I was talks with Dean. I should have just broken up with Dean and, you know, started dating Jess if I wanted. But we had this whole thing at the dance marathon and he was just irritating me. And I don't think I realized that, like, why Jess irritated me so much when he was with that other girl and everything like that. It was because, like, I liked him, of course, you know. But, you know, I was with Dean. I was, like, you know, convinced that he was my love of my life and everything. You know how it is. Well, maybe not, but still. But I just kind of found myself a bit bored with Dean. He was the safe option. He was someone my mom would approve of. But something just drawed me towards Jess. Maybe it was his love for reading, or maybe his remarks that I love to hate. You know, he just drew me in, this air of mystique. Yeah, I don't know how to explain it. Je ne sais quoi. And for sure, we failed the Bechdel test now. But yeah, I just wish it didn't have to happen this way. But yeah, life works in mysterious ways. That's no excuse. I should have just found the guts and broken up with Dean and not gone into a Jess at the dance-thon, you know. Yeah, well, of course I can be single. I just wanted to take my shot with Jess, you know, before he started dating someone else. And I really liked him, yeah. Well, that's a good question. And I don't know the answer. And I don't think I ever will. If Jess didn't come along and catch my eye, I'm not sure Dean and I would have broken up when we did. But, like, I think I still would have felt something inside me that craved more, something different. I'm sure someone else would have come along, you know, like Tristan, weakest. Lane, I'm not into bad boys. Like, can you see me right now, surrounded by books in the bookshop? Like, I am a good girl. No, that's just a trope, you know, like, just because I like reading and stuff doesn't mean I'm drawn to a bad boy, you know. Jess likes reading too. I'm not. True, you're right. Bad boys can like reading, but like Jess does. Although I wouldn't say he's a bad boy, you know. Okay, maybe a little, but just like the right amount, you know. Okay, fine, maybe I'll get a little bit attracted to bad boys. If I was dating someone as bored as me, then it would be very dull. Oh, thanks, Lane. Good to know I'm only a little bit boring, you know. Not the full package of boring. Yeah, I guess he balances me out, you're right. He's not afraid to just share his mind and what he thinks unfiltered. And of course he's really smart, although he doesn't try to be. And if he tried, like, he would do so much better in school and all that, but maybe it's, like, not the path for him. Like, he should be doing much better at school for the level of smart and, like, how much he reads and everything. But, yeah. I just know he's gonna do great things in life, and like, if any one of us is gonna lose our way, I feel like, you know, Jess has lost the star, but he's gonna find his way, you know, later in life. But I'm, if anything, you know, I have my path, like, I have my studying, but like, I may lose my way, like, you know, at college, have a crisis or whatever. Well, thanks, Lane. Anyway, enough of the blabbing. How are things with your mom and your life and everything? Same. Oh, don't say that. You know, your mom is awesome in her own way. You know, sometimes I wish my mom was like a bit more like your mom. It's like not all that's like cracked up to be having your mom more like a friend than a parent, you know. Yeah, for one thing, I have to always tell her I have to study and do homework, and she's always trying to get me to watch TV and, like, you know, laugh and have fun with her, which I love to do, of course, but, you know, I have to put school first and everything. So I have to be a bit more responsible than her sometimes. Yeah, not all the time. Like, she certainly has her mom moans every now and again, but, yeah. That's true, I wouldn't like to eat healthy all the time. Like, I think it would be good if she could cook or wanted to cook, but, you know, then I wouldn't get to eat Luke so much or fries or anything like that. Yeah, she does let me drink coffee whenever I want, which, you know, I guess your mom doesn't let you do that. Oh, yeah. You sneak it, yeah. Yeah, story that I'm compelling. I'm sure you have it much worse with your mom. She's so strict. Just letting you know that sometimes the grass is greener on the other side. You know, it's not always true. Most of the time isn't. But anyway, how's the band going? Yeah. Yeah, that's great. I'm glad you found something you're passionate about, you know. I'm kind of jealous of you, to be honest. I don't have something like that. True, high school, but something outside of that, you know what I mean? I guess I have the newspaper, but your band is very much separate from school and allows you to be creative in a different way. Of course, writing is creative, journalism not as much, but still has that creative aspect to it. True, yeah, I guess it's not too late to start something new. I just feel like I also have so much homework and then reading for class and writing for the paper on top of that. I feel like I barely have time to hang out with you and Jessica, let alone take on more extracurriculars. Although it would be good for Harvard. Yes, I know there's more to life than just doing things to participating in things to put on your college apps, but you know, I've been spending too much time with Paris lately. Not by choice, but you know, she drills it into me. She's so obsessed with getting to Harvard, you know, and that I'm like, you know, a bit brainwashed, even though of course I want to get in too. You know, I just admire you, how you've got the band, how you met Dave. How's that going, by the way? Great, tell him I said hi. Oh, I would love to, but I really have to do more research for this project tonight, otherwise Powers would literally kill me. Like, I wouldn't put it past her, you know? If it would could guarantee her an A+, she would. And yeah, of course I want to get a good grade too. Well, not good, excellent. My drawings needs to be perfect for Harvard. Sorry, you're right, I'm doing it again. Anyway, what are you and Dave doing tonight? Just practicing your music. Are you going to do anything after? I know Mrs. Kim keeps you on a tight leash, but maybe you could sneak something in. Wow, sneaking out for ice cream. She definitely wouldn't approve. What makes you want to do it more, right? Sometimes I wonder if you just do things just to piss off your mom, or do you actually like doing them? I mean, it's not hard. Her list of acceptable things is quite short. I would totally swap with you if I could. Oh, yeah, you're totally right. I don't know if I could give up my junk food. This makes me really grateful for my mom, actually. Oh, I couldn't go out without my favorite movie to wind down after a long day of school and studying. I'm suddenly very grateful for my mom, but I'm sure having a strict mom has some positives. I'm sure that's not the only positive, just that you've become a good liar. Yeah, true, I'm sorry, Lane. I just forget sometimes. I'm lucky that I don't have to hide my interests in order to avoid judgment and punishment. I wish you got the freedom to explore yourself, truly, because I believe you're incredible and that your mom should see that and you shouldn't have to hide parts of yourself from her. Yeah, I'm gonna hug my mom when I get home to thank her. Anyway, I guess we should, you know, stop all the chatting. I know I said I'd stop talking about school, but that is kind of the reason I'm here. I need to get some books for our project. But there's no way that I could afford all of these books, but some of them could be very useful, the ones that got picked out. Yeah, I guess I don't really know, like, how helpful they're going to be until I actually read them. But I got an initial explanation for an article online, and I checked them out and found some relevant passages. I got an initial explanation from an article online and then checked them out, read some relevant passages before you got here, and they all seem really good. Yeah, it's just a shame you can't borrow books from a bookstore, you know, but they'd, you know, go out of business. And it is like, you know, what a library is for. Yeah, the topic we chose, like, there wasn't much covered in the library for some reason about it. Yeah, we could have chose a different topic, but you know, Paris was quite set on this one. And like, I do find it really interesting as well. choose between these books. I have 10 here, so I should probably narrow that down to 2, maybe 3. Yeah, let's go for 3. So this one really focuses more on the negatives a bit more. So while this really like is a good book, we kind of agreed that I would focus more on the positives and benefits. So I don't want to do her job for her, you know. Yeah, maybe if I got her this book, she'd be more on my side. But let's be real, I have a book limit. I don't want to waste some books on her. And if I did get it for her, I bet she would try some way to throw what's meant to be a kind gesture, like, back in my face. She just has a way of doing that. So yeah, about this. So how about this one for more of an introduction on the topic, and this one for more detailed explanation, and like this one for case studies. Well, not exactly easy, but not too painful, although when I think of leaving the books here so lonely with no one to read them, because let's be real, not a lot of people are interested in like just learning about colonization for fun. It makes me so sad for the books. Actually, Lane, I'm pretty sure books do have feelings. How would you feel if you had to pick 3 out of 10 of your favorite rock and roll CDs? Yes. Now you understand. It would be horrible, right? Now please be a little more sympathetic, Lane. You know how I feel about books. Okay, well, anyway, I am joking. Or more a third or a quarter or 100 joking. Or more half joking or a third or a quarter or not really joking. Mostly serious, actually. So, what's the time? It's nearly 5. Oh, yeah, you have band practice. When? Oh, 5. Well, you better get going. Do you want to wait for me to put these back and buy them, or do you have to run? Well, off you fly, drummer girl. You have drums to hit. Also, I think I've had enough running for today. I had to run for the bus this morning. Bye. Have fun. Also, have fun your date. Sorry I couldn't come, but I'm sure we'd be better with just the two of you. Hope you don't have to do too much lying to your mom. Bye for now. See you later, Lane. Finally finished the research. It's not due for another 2 weeks, so Paris is a big believer in making her own internal deadlines that only she agrees with. I feel like it should be a 1 no 2 yes kind of a situation. Yeah, I know, I shouldn't let her walk all over me, but it'll be good to have it all done because I also have this big English paper that is due soon. The problem, though, is I think Paris will want to keep adding more to our project, and there is a time limit, you know, so just keep going and keep getting it more detailed and better. Isn't, if it makes it longer, isn't necessarily good, you know, because time limit, if we go over, that will, like, cut points off our presentation, you know. Yeah, that girl needs a time limit. I heard a rumor from Madeline Louise that there didn't used to be a time limit on presentation, but this teacher quickly learned that you needed to give Paris one or she wouldn't stop baking. Though the problem is, of course, I believe this annoyed her. The girl loves a challenge, so I think she just started talking really fast to get the same amount of words in, or at least, you know, close enough. Although technically, I know people can be more persuasive when they speak faster. It's like a debate technique. But there's got to be a limit, right? You have to be able to understand them with ease. You can't just talk insanely fast to compensate for a time limit. You have to be selective. That's the point, you know? Yeah, I know. Sorry, I'll shut up. I've talked enough about school for today. I was also talking about it with Lane earlier. Where are you in the movie? Oh, when Elsa confronts Rick in a deserted cafe. Then he refuses to give her the letter, right? And then she threatens him with a gun, but then confesses she still loves him. I knew I got it right. I love this movie. Well, of course you knew that, Mom. I just had to do some research for the project, and I had to look over some notes for a test I have coming up. Yeah, the work never ends. I should go to bed. Okay, I'll stay up a little bit, but I blame you if I fall asleep. Yeah, it's an exhausting day. Yeah, it was alright, I can't complain. But of course, I love school. I just wish I didn't get paired with Paris so often, you know. It seems that happens too often for it to be chance, but I guess there could always be worse, you know. Paris is a lot of things, but thorough is definitely one of them, and like, you won't get a bad grade with Paris for sure. It's not like you're with a dosser and have to do all the work, or you know, whatever. But yeah, my favorite part, seeing Elaine in the bookstore. Well, of course we're not counting breakfast with you. I love pancakes and coffee. I'm joking. I love French toast too. I'm joking. It was nice spending time with you, even if you deprive me with sugar and caffeine sometimes. Yeah, I was already at the bookstore searching for books for my research. Elaine just happened to pop in. Okay, well, yeah, I think my bookworm status is well low, and she has a 90% chance of catching me reading some books in the bookstore, so I don't think she came in to read. I think she came in to find me. Yeah, we had a good catch up. I was probably talking her ear off about school and complaining about Paris like I've been doing to you too. Sorry, but yeah, the band is good too. Dave is good. Also forgot to tell you, thank you for not being on my back all the time like Mrs. Kim. Yeah, I know I don't give you reason to, but you know, thank you for just letting me be me. And yeah, well, I mean, I know being me is just studying, but you know, if I was a rebellious person like Lane, you know, you'd be okay with that. Yeah, I know you're not Jess's biggest fan, but you haven't banned me from seeing him or locked me in my room or something. Two things Miss Kim would likely do to Lane if she found out you were dating Dave. Come on, Mom, I was trying to say I appreciate you. Yeah, I know I started it, but please don't start crying. Yeah, I found some books that seem super useful for the research of our projects. Okay, like, I'll admit, when I started, I had 10 books, but I managed to only buy 3. No, I didn't steal the others. Who do you think you're talking to? Well, it was difficult, but I just had to be brutal. I totally didn't secretly whisper to them that I would be back for them later. Well, one would have been super useful for, like, Paris part of the project. So, of course, I eliminated that one. Yeah, that's exactly what Lane said. Get her the book might get her on my side, but I don't know. I didn't want to waste one of my books on that, and I feel like she would just, like, find a way to put it against me, you know? But anyway, I got the books, had a good catch-up with Lane. She did invite me to watch band rehearsal and then to get ice cream with her and Dave. But I really had to get the research done, or Paris would literally kill me. Well, I assumed you would have let me go. Please don't start turning into Mrs. Kim. I already told